All right, guys, I'm going to show you a little, I guess you'd call it a hack that I discovered here after doing some brake work on the 2008 Ford Crown Victoria. Man, I was having a heck of a time bleeding the ABS module and getting all the air out of the entire system. And I've got the scan tool to run the ABS. I've got all the tricks, and I still couldn't get the air out. So I realized I was going to have to power bleed the vehicle. And, well, of course, the adapter that I had for my power bleeder is for a GM, a three-tab GM cap. And, of course, I'm working on a 2008 Crown Vic, in which some of those use a three-tab cap, but they seal on this center O-ring in here above my thumb instead of around the like on this one here, you see the big black rubber flat sealing washer on the Ford. It seals on that inner O-ring, and the cap is a different diameter altogether. So I ordered this particular cap, and it comes all the way up here to a threaded fitting. This is from Motive Products. I'll get your part number down below. I'll put a link to it. And instead of using the typical Motive bleeder like I've used before, you can use this thing two different ways. You can either fill it full of liquid, brake fluid, and then it will keep your master cylinder full of fluid and pressurized while you're bleeding your brakes. Or you can use this just as a pressure supply, no liquid in the tank. You just pump it up with air, and it will keep your master cylinder pressurized while you're going around the four corners bleeding the brakes. The problem with that method is you got to make sure that your master cylinder doesn't run dry. But the advantage is you don't get this tank all funky with different types of brake fluid and, you know, turn it into a big mess. So I choose to just use this as a pressure source and keep the fluid out of it and just make sure that the master cylinder doesn't run dry. So now, with that said, I buy the correct cap for my vehicle, and I was thinking the other day, well, if I'm only using that, this tank is basically just a garden sprayer. Here, let me show you. It's hard to do here with one hand. The handle just comes out, and it's a pump. You know, it's like a typical garden sprayer. So I'm thinking, well, man, if I'm just going to use that thing as a pressure supply, well, I've got an air compressor to do that. And before anybody gets in the comments, yes, I realize that using air with no isolation bladder between the air and your brake fluid. Brake fluid is hydroscopic. It absorbs moisture. Well, I get all that. But this Motive power bleeder already defies that to begin with, because you're using air right on the fluid. And second of all, my shop compressor hardly ever runs. The last time I ran my shop compressor was probably a month and a half ago. So by now, any moisture that's in the air has already dropped out of the air, and it's now as water in the bottom of the air tank. So I have a shutoff valve on my compressor that I turn off when I'm not using the tank or using the air compressor at all. So my compressor never leaks down. I've got air pressure in there. I got 90 PSI in there from a month and a half ago. So the pump has not ran and created more moisture. Anyway, with that said, I realize it's still not 100% perfect, but I'm doing it anyway. Go to Harbor Freight, get yourself a pressure regulator like you would buy for one of their paint guns. You get an air nipple. I had a shutoff valve in my plumbing kit, so I just put a valve there, put the regulator on, and then you can buy these, hold on a second, let me grab the package. You can buy these air filters here. It's called a spray gun filter. It says removes water, oil, and dust particles from the airline, minimize paint defects. So put that on the low pressure side of the regulator, and then just screw your brake bleeding cap into here. And then now this gauge obviously is overkill. You can put any gauge in here. In fact, I think these regulators come with a gauge, and if they don't, just get whatever little gauge they got. I don't like to bleed my systems anywhere between, I had it up at one point today up to 20 PSI, but I usually like to stick around 15. Now, let me show you something real quick. So over at my shop compressor, yeah, I know it's dirty in this corner. Just forgive the mess. I hardly get back here ever. You can see I've got the main line coming out with a shutoff valve. It's off at this time. and then it comes through and I got a big disconnect for big impact guns, and then I've got just a little line disconnect for standard air hose fittings. But before any of that, I've got a regulator that comes off, and I got a regulated port here. So all I do is I take my air hose off of my standard unregulated port and I put it up here, and now I can regulate my main airline pressure down to whatever I want. And I regulated this down to about 20 PSI. And so therefore, by the time it gets to the end of this, you know, 25 foot or 50 foot hose, whatever it is, it's still going to be 20 or under. And, you know, there's hardly any flow when you're bleeding brakes. And so flow would affect the pressure. But because there's hardly any flow, you know, if you stop up the airflow, eventually it does reach regulator setting. So at the end of my air hose is 20 PSI. And then the regulator at the actual bleed cap, which I just showed you, I can fine tune it from there. So like I said, I realized this gauge is overkill. This came off of my air conditioning pressure switch testing rig for testing pressure switches. It's overkill. You don't need that, but it is nice to have. And like I said, it doesn't matter where you're bleeding. You don't have to be right down to the pound. I just like to be 20 or under. So, you know, just regulate this thing. Make sure you're under 20. You know, you could probably go higher. Some guys probably do go up to 30 PSI. But now I'm worried about, you know, blowing the reservoir off the master cylinder and stuff like that. So, but anyway, once you get this all hooked up, you put your air hose on there. And then you can go around and bleed all the brakes. And you don't have to worry about ever sucking anything in. Whether, you know, you got someone helping you, you know, push down, open the bleeder, close the bleeder, release. Or if you're trying to do a manual bleed procedure with the scan tool that says to open the bleed valve and then go back in the vehicle and pump the brakes. Well, I did that two or three times. And by the time this piece showed up, because I had to order it on Amazon, and of course it came a day late, by the time that showed up, after I did the automated bleed process with the scan tool three times, once I put this on and bled the brakes by power bleeding, I still had bubbles coming out of all four calipers. So anyway, if you're working on a Ford or any vehicle, you just need a different cap, adapter cap, and you're looking for a cheap way to power bleed, this might be a setup for you. I realize this is not 100% the approved procedure because of the air and the moisture, but you know, I mean, unless you want to go out and spend, you know, I don't know what they are. They're the type of power bleeder where it's got a bladder between the air pressure and the brake fluid. You know, an actual true power bleeder, those things cost a fortune. So if you're just doing one or two vehicles, here you go. This is your answer. I'll put links down below for the adapter that I use. This is the 3-tab Ford adapter that's for later model Crown Victorias, F-150s, I think maybe a few Mustangs. Otherwise, I'll put a link down below to all the rest of the adapters that this will work with. So, all right. Please be sure to like, share, and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.